Hello friends, welcome to your channel Learning More with Prerna. Friends, I am Prerna and please do like, share and subscribe to your channel Learning More with Prerna. Friends, so friends, today I have come with another topic on demographic profile of Karnataka, which comes under Karnataka economy. So let us see what is the demographic profile of Karnataka, introduction of that and importance of demographic profile of Karnataka. So when we come to the introduction, friends, we can see that there is a direct relationship between the demography and economic growth, that is population and economic growth. When the population grows, the economy also grows, right? The demography refers to the population and human resources also. So when the human resources grow, the economy will grow. And human resources refers to the knowledge, education level and skills of an individual. So let us see what is the importance of demographic profile of Karnataka. So friends, the first point is efficient use of natural resources. When the population is more, we want more natural resources. So we are going to use these natural resources in an optimum way so that we can fulfill our satisfaction. So we are going to use it in an optimum way. Next, it protects army. When we have a huge population, the huge population will be going to army. So the huge population is there in army or in our defense, we can see that we will be protected because we have so many soldiers in the borders. The next point is development of transportation. When the population is more, then the transportation need to be good so that the population can travel easily. As the population increases, the transportation need to be improved because we have huge population and a huge population wants a good transportation system so that they can travel easily. And when the population grows, the transportation will improve because the new modern technology will be coming. So because of this modern technology, we can see a development or improvement in the transportation. Next, supply of labor power. When we have a huge population, the supply of labor power will be more. We can supply huge number of workers for a particular task. The next point is responsible for both consumption and production. So this huge population is responsible both for consumption and the production of goods and services. The product which is produced will be consumed by the other person and the consumed product will be produced by the other person. So we can see that there is a cycle and the production and consumption will be taking place in a society. Because of this huge population, the consumption and the production will have a balance and this will take place. And we can see a continuous cycle between consumption and production. The next one is supply of skill and intelligence. When we have a huge population, we will be having more competition. So what we are going to do? We are going to take some skills. We are going to learn some skills and we will become an intelligent person. So because of this more population or huge population, we can see that we are going to develop our skills and knowledge. Next, another plus point is that more population will help us to do a good administration. Effective administration will be done. Because of huge population, we can see that the policy will be made properly and the implementation and the plan will go properly. So huge population plays an important role for the efficient administration also. So here I conclude my video and please do like, share and subscribe to your channel Learning More with Prerna. Thank you. Please share this video to your friends so that it will help them and even it will encourage me to make more and more such videos. Thank you so much.